But in the nature of the allowance, you must teach the child four things. First, they don't get to keep everything they get. The first thing that they lose is 10% or 20% to taxes. Let them learn. When did you first learn about taxes? Remember your first paycheck? Who was FICA? So withhold 20%. If you're going to give them 10 bucks as an allowance, take $2 away. Tell them you're doing it. This is taxes. It goes toward money in the house, right? Like, get used to it, kid. This is the world. Number two, with money comes opportunity. Money should be recognized as a good thing, and they should be encouraged to enjoy their money, to spend some of it on whatever they want, within constraints of a parental, but I mean, nothing illicit or bad or inappropriate, but if they want to buy a comic book, let them. If they want to buy a candy bar, if you're okay with candy bars, let you. If they want to do whatever, let them go do it with a little bit of their money, with some of their money. But with some of their money, they also have to understand that with the opportunity comes responsibility. And that means helping others. So 10% should go toward charity. Let them choose the charity. And they may choose that the charity is a friend of theirs who's hungry at lunch. It may be a kid down the street, let alone the Red Cross. Let them decide who to get their money and help them learn how to figure that out and how to determine who's worthy and how to measure impact and how to evaluate effectiveness. And finally, recognize that while they're going to enjoy some of their money on that comic book today, some of the things they will enjoy doing with their money, they can't afford to do today. They can't afford that bicycle, because that's a lot of money. They can't afford the car or college, because those are very big ticket items in the future. So have them save a little toward the future. So if you tax a little, give a little, spend a little, and save a little, you'll be helping to raise money-smart children.